Hey y'all, it's Manny from My Hectic Life, and today we're going to talk about preventable diseases in frogs. Many species of frogs are kept as pets all over the world. Most frogs tend to be considered a beginner pet and are relatively easy to care for. They tend to be pretty hardy, but like all pets, they can be susceptible to certain diseases. If you find that you have any health concerns about your pet frog, you should definitely contact your veterinarian just to make sure everything's all right. But most diseases that frogs tend to get are usually pretty easy to prevent. So, of course, there's metabolic bone disease. Metabolic bone disease is caused typically from a lack of calcium in the diet. Metabolic bone disease is an easy prevention as since it is just caused by a lack of vitamin D3 and a lack of calcium, sprinkling a calcium vitamin D3 supplement every other feeding can help prevent this disease from happening. Metabolic bone disease causes soft bones and problems with the jaw to where your amphibian won't be able to eat. Another easy fix for this can be the addition of a UVB light if your frog is compatible with UVB. Many albino type species and things cannot handle a lot of extra lighting. So make sure that you do research whether or not your pet can handle a UVB light. If they can't, then of course a calcium vitamin D3 supplement every other feeding is recommended for your frogs. Another disease that is common among frogs can be toxic out syndrome. Frogs have very sensitive skin and they absorb pretty much anything around them. They absorb water through their skin, and so if you're not changing their water bowl frequently and making sure that you are using dechlorinated water, then they can develop toxic out syndrome. Signs of this illness can be spastic jumping, cloudy eyes, and listless limbs. Even things like smoking around your frogs, handling your frogs too much, the oils of our skin can be very dangerous for frogs if they're exposed to it too much. These can all contribute to toxic out syndrome, as well as just keeping their habitat well clean and maintenance and making sure that they get their water changed regularly. I know my frogs tend to go to the bathroom in their bowls, and so we really don't want them sitting and soaking in their own urine and feces infested water. The third illness that we can talk about is parasites. So to help prevent your frog from getting parasites, it's simple. Just make sure that you're not feeding any outside insects, that you're only feeding insects that were bred for the purposes of feeding and mice that were bred for the purposes of feeding, and not something that you caught outside in a field. Another typical problem with frogs can be impaction. Frogs can get impacted by accidentally consuming unsafe substrate. If you're using things like gravel or moss, you want to just be very careful, because if the frog is eating and they accidentally ingest a rock or they ingest some of the moss, these things can cause impaction. So you want to make sure that whatever substrate you're using and anything that you keep in your tank is going to be something that's safe for your frog and either too large for them to even try to ingest, or small enough that can easily pass through their system so it won't cause any obstructions. Another common problem found in frogs can be obesity. Most frog species are gluttonous, big, heavy-duty eaters. Especially if you own something like a Pac-Man frog. They will eat themselves almost to death. They will just gorge themselves full of food. Obesity can be a huge problem among frogs if we don't keep an eye on how much we are feeding and how often we are feeding. I try and stay on a schedule. That way I know when to feed my frogs and how much according to how large they are. If you do notice that your frog is starting to get kind of fat and starting to have a harder time moving around, you're probably going to want to either cut back on feedings. Either you're feeding too often or you're feeding too much at one time. So if that's the case, then you're just going to want to cut back on that a little bit. Another huge problem that we see among frogs can be dehydration. Dehydration is probably the easiest thing to prevent. Making sure that in your frog's habitat you are maintaining proper humidity levels, making sure that you're spraying down your tank, using dechlorinated water, and making sure that you're providing plenty of fresh water for them every day. If you're doing all this, then your frog more than likely will never have any kind of problems with dehydration unless there's another underlying cause. Another illness that can cause problems with your frog is gastric overload. If you feed your frog something that is too large for them to handle, or sometimes if you feed too much at one time in one feeding, they can sometimes get gastric overload, which can cause a lot of bloating, a lot of discomfort in your frog, and can put pressure on their lungs and other organs that can cause them a lot of problems long term. So you always want to make sure that you're not feeding anything too large to your frogs and that you're not overfeeding your frogs too much in one feeding, because again, most of them have a pretty voracious appetite and they can overeat, and this can make them very ill. So you always want to monitor how much you're feeding your frogs and how much you should be feeding your frogs in one sitting and how often. This will help prevent making sure that they don't ever end up with gastric overload. Now the last one that I want to talk about is hypothermia and heat stroke. Now hypothermia is a lot more common than heat stroke, but it is so easy to prevent. For hypothermia, you just don't want the frogs tank temperatures to fall below a comfortable level. Several different species of frogs, their temperature range is usually between 65 and 80 degrees. Some can go a little bit higher than this. But overall, you want to make sure that for your species of frog, that you're keeping their tank temperatures at the correct levels. You don't want them to be fluctuating too much too quickly, and you want to make sure that your frogs are always warm enough. Now, on the opposite side of the spectrum, for heat stroke, for areas like where I live, where it can get to be 115 degrees outside on a regular basis in summer, if you don't believe in your air conditioner, then that can also be a huge problem for your frogs. So you want to make sure that you are keeping your frogs in a cooler area in your house if you do have problems with overheating. For keeping your tanks warm, there are all kinds of things in the winter, like there's all kinds of different products out there, ceramic heat lamps, heating mats that you can put under the tank or even attach to the side of some tanks. And of course there's heat lamps like your day and night basking bulbs that can also provide warmth to your tank depending on what type of species that you have and what they do best with. Like the Pac-Man frogs and my tree frogs do better with either a ceramic heating lamp or an under the tank mat. But other species may do better with a basking bulb. It just depends on how sensitive your species of frog that you're keeping as a pet is to light. So of course there are still other diseases that your frogs can get. I mean, there are viral infections and fungal infections and bacterial infections that are just not very easy to prevent. But overall, a lot of these diseases are very preventable. So armed with this knowledge, you can have a frog that will have a much longer lifespan and be a lot happier and healthier overall. So that's all for today's video. If you found this information useful, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel, where I post videos like this every week. Thanks for watching, guys. Bye!